Hello everyone, welcome to Morning English, this is Cecilia.
Hi guys, 欢迎大家收听早安英文 this is Nora.
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Hey, Cici, I saw the picture you posted yesterday. 你照片里面的那个小女孩是谁呀？
Ah, that's my niece. Isn't she just adorable?
Right? She's so cute. 我非常客观公正地说啊，不带任何滤镜，这个小女孩感觉都可以去做童星了。
Yeah, she's like the cutest thing ever. 你还别说啊，她爸妈好像真的有意把她往那方面培养，各种舞蹈班啊，小主持人班啊，都没断过。But I don't know.
What?
Well, I'm not her parent, so it's not my place to say, but...I'm just not sure whether it's a good thing for her. After all, she's only four.
也是啊，想想我们四岁的时候都在干什么。
我都不记得我在干什么，大概是在玩泥巴吧。
Me too. 但确实呢，有的小童星啊，三岁就出道了，甚至还有很多不会说话的小宝宝都已经在社交网站上吸粉无数了。No wonder parents these days are so anxious.They're so afraid to fall behind.
不说赢在起跑线上，至少不能落后，对吧？那 fall behind 它就表示落后、掉队的意思。也是哦，人张爱玲就说了，出名要趁早。Besides, there are some child stars that I really like. It would be a pity if they never got to appear on TV.
这么说来呢，我好像还真的不怎么关注童星哎。你要是问我喜欢哪些童星，我都说不上来。
Well, I'm sure there are some you must know.那接下来我要说的这几个人你肯定有印象的，而且呢你肯定会被他们的魅力折服的。
OK, I'm all ears. Before we start, quick heads up for our listeners.
在我开始案例之前啊，我们先来看看 Nora 刚刚说的这句话。 I'm all ears, 我全是耳朵。很有意思啊，其实呢这里是用了一个表达 Be all ears, 它就表示全神贯注的倾听，也就是我们常说的洗耳恭听的意思。
Okay, I just cut it to the chase. Who's your favorite child star?
You know it is always hard to answer these kind of questions. 最喜欢的？你很难去评判谁是你最喜欢的。不过呢，有一个人，我真的是看他的动图看了20遍，根本停不下来，太可爱了。
Okay, who is it?
就是被称为天才童星的芦田爱菜。She was so cute.Besides, she was a really talented actress. Have you watched any of her films? 比方说这个《再见我的幼儿园》
No.
白兔糖、厕所女神
I think the first one, yes, and the second one, no.
还有《环太平洋》应该看过吧
Oh, yeah. This one I know, but I can hardly remember her part in the film.
You've got to watch these films, I promise you. Once you watch these films, you will fall in love with her.
All right. Now you sound like a crazy fan. Only your idol is a little girl.
Yes, she was a little girl. 现在人家已经是亭亭玉立的大姑娘了。只不过呢，她三岁就出道了。那像出演我刚刚说的那些电影的时候呢，也就六七岁的样子。She was such a sweet cutie pie. No one could resist her charm. No one.
Okay, 可以看出来啊。那别人我是不知道，你已经是完全沦陷了。那如果我们和 Cici 一样，被一个非常可爱的人迷得神魂颠倒，我们就可以形容他为 cutie pie, 相当于是小甜心、小可爱的意思。
Right, 想象一下，你什么时候会对着一个人说你就是我的可爱小饼干。
Never. I would never ever say that. 太肉麻了，好吧。
少来啊，你可没少对你家猫说，下次给你录下来。
Okay, back to our topic. So, as you said, the little girl has grown up. 我们知道呢，很多童星长大了之后都慢慢地淡出了公众的视野了。那芦田爱菜呢，她现在怎么样了？
Well, she's still working as an actress, but certain things did happen.一个呢就是她曾经被日本民众投票为最不想看见的女明星。
How? You just said everyone loves her. Besides, she was just a little girl.
That's exactly the reason. 就是因为她年纪那么小啊，然后有一段时间她一直在上节目，只要一打开电视就是她的脸。
I see. No matter how cute she was, people could be tired of watching the same face every day.
Not only that, some of the shows she was in are kind of vulgar to watch. Imagine a little girl dancing with a bunch of shirtless guys. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, totally.从可爱的少女呢变成了这种恶俗的综艺咖，观众确实是非常难接受的。那我们形容一个东西低俗不雅呢，就可以用到 vulgar 这个词来形容。
没错，而且你想啊，天天上节目说明什么？说明她行程满呀。
嗯，对哦，从几岁就开始996了，这得多可怕呀。
Especially for a growing child, right?
Yeah, they're so delicate during that stage.This heavy workload can bring about a physical, emotional, and mental change in them.
你说到点上了，很多粉丝都觉得呢，就是因为他在长身体的时候没有好好的休息啊，导致他现在身高1.5米都没有到。那我们说某事导致了，引起了另外一件事情呢，就可以用 bring about 这个动词短语。
Yeah, I guess this is something incidental to fame and success.
年少成名呢并不只有风光无限啊，也免不了会伴随着一些伤心事啊。那刚刚用了 incidental 这个形容词， If something is incidental to something, 我们就说这件事呢是伴随着另一件事情而来的，免不了的。
Well, when it comes to child stars, this is not a single case.就凭我自己非常少的了解的童星里面啊，前些年里面有一个国民儿子小小兵，还有就是前段时间铺天盖地被报道的童模妞妞，都是小小年纪就被他的爸爸妈妈当作是赚钱工具了。
It's heartbreaking to read about their experience. Yeah, it brought another child star to my mind, a counter example.跟你刚刚说的这些人相比啊，这个小男孩的父母呢就真的是人间清醒了。给你一点提示啊，韩国的坏笑男孩。
坏笑男孩，我只知道假笑男孩 Gavin。 But isn't he another victim of the sudden celebrityhood?
是不是，是韩国的。哎呀，我还看过你用他的表情包呢，是他演过的一个电影里面的，叫做《非常主播》
啊。我知道了，就是三分讥笑，两分薄凉，五分漫不经心的表情包，是不是？Yeah, he's so funny and cute. How come I never saw him after the film? What happened to him?
Yeah, he kind of faded out of sight afterwards.确实啊，他没有拍几部戏呢，就慢慢的淡出了大众的视野。那 fade out 这个短语呢，它就表示逐渐淡出的意思。那所以表达一个人淡出公众视野，我们就可以用 fade out of sight 这个表达。
Well, this isn't a bad choice. He got to concentrate on his schoolwork and take his time. There is really no need to hurry.
Yeah, I agree. 人生那么长，对吧？想要成功，有的是机会。But once your childhood is gone, there is nothing you can do to get it back.
Right. So can I ask you a question?
Yes.
So if you were offered a chance to become famous as a child star, would you choose to accept it?
Yes.
那其实说了这么多，你还是拒绝不了当明星的诱惑，是不是？
Well, what's the worst case scenario? I lose my fame and go back to normal life?That's what I am now. What do I have to lose?
也是。最坏的情况呢，不过就是回归平淡嘛。那这个 worst case scenario 就是指最坏的情况。I gotta say, I like your attitude.
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢，是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频了。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
好了，那这期节目呢就到这里结束啦。
So, thank you so much for listening. This is Cecilia.
This is Nora. See you next time.
Bye.